earthquake provision.
So if a 6.9 quake were to hit in Memphis, in Charleston, in Salt Lake City, would the devastation be much worse than we've seen here?
It could be much worse for several reasons. One is that buildings have not been designed for earthquakes as they have in California. And the second is that for certain geological reasons, the same earthquake, same magnitude earthquake in the east would affect a much larger area. Let's take the earthquake in California. It would affect an area like this, and a similar magnitude would affect a much larger area. So the extent of damage could be much greater.
Also because what? Because the land is flat and the shockwaves would travel more freely?
It's a little bit complex. It's not well understood. But the Earth is more fractured in California, so the seismic waves don't travel as far.
Uh-huh. Dr. Heaton, as I come back to you, let me note again that you're part of Los Angeles' Preparedness Advisory Committee. Let me try to contrast, if I might, the freeway system here and the one down there, the landfill areas here and the landfill areas down there. And you talked to me a little bit about the preparation. How prepared is LA's freeway system, although it's been reinforced, to not sustain the kind of damage that San Francisco's did?
Well, I'd like to make a couple of points. The first is that the United States has two cities that have really spent considerable effort preparing for earthquakes. They're San Francisco and Los Angeles. And if we could move to this map over here, this earthquake This earthquake we just had was a magnitude 6.9, about 60 miles south of the San Francisco earthquake. And however, it's important to realize that in 1906, there was an earthquake an entire one magnitude unit larger, which means 30 times larger in energy, which went right through the city of San Francisco. That was on the San Andreas Fault. Earthquakes of that type will happen again sometime in the West Coast, and they will be right through the city. So whatever happened in this 6.9, it would be far worse for that type of earthquake.
Sure.
Now, if we move down the state to the Southern California area, then we get down to the San Andreas Fault just north of Los Angeles.
I'm sorry, I'm going to have to interrupt you. I mean, we're going to have to go to a break right here. I've got to leave it there, and thank you very much, Dr. Heaton and Professor Gergely at Cornell. This is Today on NBC.
Bee to the blossom, moth to the flame, each to his passion. What's in a name? Depends on the name. Shakespeare from Julius Caesar. Passion, I see, is catching. I sure hope so.
Elizabeth Taylor's Passion. And now, Elegant Whispers. Your gift with any purchase from the Elizabeth Taylor's Passion collection. Available at Strawbridge and Clothier.
Let me ask you something. When you need help on a job, do you turn to a neighbor you trust or a stranger off the street? Well, Channel Home Centers has been a neighbor for over 80 years. They've always carried the name brands you trust at prices you can count on.
Like this Stanley Toilet Tank Repair Kit. It includes a toilet refill valve, a flapper tank ball and chain, and a flexible refill tube. Right now, it's yours free after a $5 manufacturer's rebate when you purchase any toilet seat from Channel.
Hey, Channel has been a neighbor for 80 years. Now, why would you want to go talking to strangers?
If you love sports car excitement, but you need a bit more room.
Shift to Pontiac excitement. The 1990 Grand Prix Sedan. Legendary performance and value. All new four-door style. Grand Prix LE is sticker priced over $1,000 less than Honda Accord LX. Plus, you get $600 cash back. Shift to Pontiac excitement. See why Pontiac outsells all the imports. See your Pontiac pace setters now.
The ultimate leather experience at John's. It's rich. It's luxurious. It's lasting. It's on sale now. 30 to 40% off. Don't buy leather until you see John's. John's Interiors, Route 309 Montgomeryville, Route 70 Cherry Hill, Street Road, Southampton.
In London's Westminster Abbey this morning, some of the most distinguished names of the British stage and film held a memorial service for their friend, the late actor Sir Laurence Olivier. Olivier died last July at the age of 82. Today, foreign editor Dennis Murphy has a report on the tribute.
They gathered in the Abbey where the kings and queens of England are buried, the royal family of the British stage and screen. They moved in procession to the high altar carrying artifacts of Olivier's career. The crown he wore in Richard III, his script from Hamlet.
To be or not to be, that is the question. Whether it is nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune.
Laurence Olivier received from God a unique and awesome talent, which he used to the full. Today we come to remember him, to ask of God forgiveness for his faults.
He hath made everything beautiful in his time. Also, he hath set the world in their heart, so that no man can find out the work that God maketh from the beginning to the end.
Olivier created a gallery of characters. He called what he did tricks, a bag of winks and false noses. But generations of audiences knew it for what it was, great art, an actor who always surprised.
Now are our brows bound with victorious wreaths, our bruised arms hung up for monuments, our stern alarums changed to merry meetings, our dreadful marches to delightful measures.
His widow, the actress Joan Plowright, heard Olivier's friends say goodbye with readings from the scriptures and the great English poets.
There entertain him all the saints above, in solemn troops and sweet societies that sing and singing in their glory move, and wipe the tears forever from his eyes.
One short sleep past, we wake eternally, and death shall be no more. Death, thou shalt die.
For he today that sheds his blood with me shall be my brother, be he ne'er so base, and gentlemen in England now abed shall think themselves accursed they were not here, and hold their manhood's cheap. While then he speaks that fought with us upon St. Crispin's Day!
A full life lived generously and shared with all of us. He has, I am sure, the nation's gratitude. Good night, sweet prince. And flights of angels sing thee to thy rest.
For today, Dennis Murphy and...
We're going to have yet another half hour of the Today program, even as we think about celebrating a human life, Sir Laurence Olivier. We'll find a wealth of other human stories in San Francisco after station break.
One tough DA, two identical murder suspects. She may let the wrong one go.
Got the wrong man on trial, Lynn.
Felicia Rashad, Philip Michael Thomas, the premiere of False Witness Monday. He's the Baryshnikov of the backfield. Randall Cunningham is the most graceful quarterback in the NFL. But this week, he learned some new moves from the Pennsylvania Ballet. Watch Randall and defensive lineman Jerome Brown go up on their toes on The Randall Cunningham Show with Lou Tilley, Saturday at 7:30 on Channel 3. Beverly's back, and a good news team is getting better. Eyewitness News, weeknights 6 and 11, KYW-TV, Channel 3. This is Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
Good morning, I'm Kim Adams. Here's the rainy forecast. It will be windy, milder today with rain or drizzle, the high near 62. It's 59 degrees at the airport and 58 in Center City. Philadelphia Mayor Wilson Good is said to be in stable condition this morning after being rushed to the hospital complaining of an ill feeling. The 51-year-old mayor is at the University of Pennsylvania Hospital in West Philadelphia. Overnight, he was visited by his wife, Velma, his children, and high-ranking city officials. A statement on the mayor's condition was issued by spokeswoman Karen Warrington.
Mayor Good was taken to Lankenau Hospital approximately 1:15 this morning. He said he thought his blood pressure might be high. He said that he had a general feeling of, a general ill feeling. He was examined at Lankenau, and it was determined that his condition was stable and that he could be transferred to the University of Penn Hospital for further evaluation.
The mayor has suffered from high blood pressure in the past, but Warrington is not sure if he's taking medication. Federal officials, meanwhile, are warning Pennsylvania health officials that three flu strains are headed this way. The Center for Disease Control in Atlanta told the Pennsylvania Health Department yesterday to expect possible outbreaks of A. Taiwan, A. Shanghai, and B. Yamagata flu strains. Most people recover from the flu within a week, but the elderly and those with respiratory problems are being urged to get flu shots. High tides and a lot of rain made it rough for some folks in Atlantic City and other shore towns yesterday. Streets and lawns became lakes. The bays backed up onto the land because of what experts say are unusually high tides caused by a rare moon and sun alignment. Two new developments this morning in the area's school strikes. In Phoenixville, the school district last night rejected a request by striking teachers to call in an arbitrator. And in Bristol Borough, the school board announced it would seek a court order to force its striking teachers back to the classroom. It's time now for our last traffic check of the morning, so we turn now to Pete Roscoe and Shadow Traffic. Good morning again, Pete.
Good morning again, Kim. Southbound 95 backed up from Cottman Avenue down through Girard. Northbound in Delaware County is a two-mile delay by McDade Boulevard. The eastbound Platte Bridge jammed almost the entire length to the light at 26th Street, where there's an accident blocking the lane. And still jammed up at the Tacony-Palmyra Bridge, their second opening of the morning completed just a few minutes ago. Pete Roscoe reporting with a Sunoco traffic update.
There is a perfect place with rivers and rolling hills, a magical moon and a hot tropical sun, surrounded by water on three shining coasts, with a big playground in the middle and an airline right to it all. The place is Florida. The airline is Eastern. The time to go is now. Eastern has a hot $99 fare each way to one of nine perfect Florida cities. Eastern to Florida, coast to coast to coast. Perfect.
Listen, there is a new tool that's designed to make any job a lot easier, and it's available only at Channel Home Centers. It's the Channel Good Neighbor Charge Card, the tool you can use to get whatever you need to get the job done.
You can use it at Channel to get this EMCO 32x80-inch white Forever Storm Door, made of rugged structural polypropylene, pre-hung for easy installation, and this week is just $177.99.
The Channel Good Neighbor Charge Card. Like any useful tool, it has your name on it so that the neighbors can't borrow it all the time.
In sports, Ron Hextall is back with the Flyers organization. The announcement of his return came yesterday, and he's expected to attend practice today. But he won't be playing with the team just yet. The All-Star goaltender must still finish serving a 12-game suspension imposed by the NHL. The penalty followed his attack on a Montreal player during last season's playoff series. Hextall will be eligible to play again on November 4th. Checking the community calendar, the Bucks County branch of the NAACP will hold its major fundraising event, the 38th Annual Freedom Fund Banquet at Fisher's Tudor House in Bensalem, PA. It starts at 6:15 tonight. For more information, just call 215-788-9467. Here's the forecast again. It will be windy and mild today with rain or drizzle, the high near 62. 59 at the airport, 58 in Center City. I'm Kim Adams. Join us at noon with Trudy Hayne. We'll have more from the entertainment world.
Introducing the totally redesigned 1990 four-wheel drive Toyota 4Runner. Now the additional performance from its available V6 is combined with additional comfort, additional necessities, and additional doors. Where you go in your new four-door Toyota 4Runner is your concern. Getting you back is ours.
Missing Rewards, tonight at 7:30, only on Channel 3.
back now at 8:30 on a Friday morning, and as we head towards a weekend, the recovery efforts are continuing here in the Bay Area. We're going to continue to look to them. We'll do so in this half hour with a gentleman who has answered our wake-up call. Tom Brokaw is standing by. He'll be stepping in to join us shortly. Let's go back to New York once again. Jane, how you doing?
Oh, we're doing great. Thank you, Bryant. Renee Taylor and Joseph Bologna have been working together as actors for more than 20 years. They have a new movie. It's an old-fashioned love story. As is their life. They've been married for 24 years or so. They'll be here in this half hour.
And Jane, will close out this week in I think rather appropriate fashion. We've got a video summation of sorts of the last 63 hours, some of the images that have been captured here in the Bay Area, images that figure to stay with us for a lifetime. We've assembled them together. It's a piece I don't think many people will want to miss. Let's go back to the news one final time on this busy week and to Deborah Norville. Deborah?
Thank you, Brian. President Bush today will be getting a first-hand close-up look at the devastation in Northern California caused by the earthquake Tuesday. The president, who says he wants the federal government to stay on top of the relief effort, will be spending about 3 hours in the Bay Area. Mr. Bush, after landing at Moffett Naval Air Station, will tour the quake area by both helicopter and automobile, stopping in Oakland and in Santa Cruz, a seaside town where the earthquake has left an estimated 10,000 people homeless. The aftershocks are still rolling through the area this morning, 2.5 days after the quake hit. This morning, the latest aftershock measured 3.5 on the Richter scale. Officials in the area are hopeful that the official death toll from the earthquake will not be as great as was feared. They are finding fewer victims than they expected on that collapsed section of Interstate 880 in Oakland. As NBC's Roger O'Neill told us earlier this morning on Today, rescue crews report checking one quarter-mile section of the collapsed roadway without finding any vehicles. They say traffic apparently was lighter than usual because a lot of motorists have left work early so they could watch the World Series on television. Reports from China say that rescue workers have found more bodies in the rubble of a series of earthquakes there over the past 2 days in northern China. At least 29 people were killed in those earthquakes. And officials say a badly damaged dam is in danger of collapsing and flooding a heavily populated area. And we should report there was also an earthquake today south of Rome, Italy. Italian authorities report there were no injuries, and they say that structural damage appears to be minimal. The astronauts on board the space shuttle Atlantis are turning their attention to science and filmmaking today. They're measuring the Earth's ozone layer, filming Typhoon Elise and several volcanoes, and taking photographs of some sites from the Grand Canyon to Tokyo. The shuttle and its 5-member crew are scheduled to return home Monday. Some of the pictures they're taking will be put on display at the Smithsonian Institute in Washington. Former President and Mrs. Reagan have begun an 8-day visit to Japan. The Reagans were given a red carpet welcome at Tokyo Airport this morning. Though officially they are guests of the Japanese government, the Reagans are being paid to make a series of appearances for a Japanese communications firm. Their fee, reportedly $2 million. A new poll indicates a startling drop in President Bush's popularity. The survey conducted for the Boston Globe and television station WBZ shows that President Bush's popularity has dropped 10 points from last week. The pollsters attribute the decline to the handling of the attempted coup in Panama, trouble on Wall Street, and the president's threat to veto an abortion funding bill. They say the biggest drop in Mr. Bush's popularity occurred among women. And that's our last look at the news on what's been a pretty eventful week. I didn't get a chance to ask you, when you guys went out to San Francisco, did you have misgivings about it?
Yes.
I mean, you know, a sense of trepidation?
Yes. There were at least three parts of me who were talking to each other about whether we wanted to go or not,
and the part that was talking to the boss won.
The part that the boss was talking to, yes, definitely won. But of course, I had some feelings about that, which I think are only human. Which is being a human person was probably why I should have gone.
Absolutely.
Yes, but thank you for asking. Willard Scott joins us now, and I only wish that Willard could have gone too, because frankly, the Bay Area needs a little touch of Willard.
Well, you know, I'd love to go out there, Jane, and I was hoping that maybe, you know, in the heat of everything that's happening right now, there's so much attention placed on it. As we did in Charleston, we waited a week, and then I went down there and did some work. Maybe after things sort of cool down a little bit. And what we do is work with the volunteers when they have more time to talk and everything. Right now they're at fever pitch, but I would love to. I would hope they'd do that. I'd love to do that, Marty. I really would love to do that. You hear so many stories, there have been so many tragic stories, but a friend of mine told me one that, while it's not a funny, hilarious story, but there's so many things you just don't think about. She was in her home, and she said when the earthquake hit, and she was trying to get an old clock off the mantle that she'd had for years and wanted to save it, and she looked in, and there's 16,000 gallons of swimming pool water rushing into her living room, and she just got out of the house as fast as she could. So aside from the tragedies, there are 10 million little stories that happened out there. I guess you just don't think about it, and there's no time to cover things like that. But everything's on the mend now, and we'll be in better shape. This is a nice T-shirt from Texas. This is Flatonia, Texas, 1,000 people strong near Austin, near San Antonio. Anybody in the state of Texas can get there. Big chili cook-off this weekend. Some of the best German food you ever had in your life. Check it out. A couple of birthdays as we sort of waddle into the weekend. This is Violet Oliver of Kennett, Missouri. 100 years old today. Lives kind of in the boot heel of Missouri, she says. And this is Elsie Hill, a very pretty, lovely lady from Washington, D.C., 102 years old today. She is 5'2" and eyes of blue. And coochie-coochie-coochie-coo. Has anybody seen Miguel? Cold temperatures continue Saturday through the Great Lakes with snow flurries lingering and rain in the northeast, but clearing up and sunny in the southeast and more rain and snow mixing into the Cascades in the northwest. Good old San Francisco, prepare for colder weather. It's probably hit this morning, but by tonight it'll be rainy and then looks like kind of a rainy weekend for you. Here's what's happening in your world even as we speak this morning.
For today, we'll find it windy, milder with rain or drizzle, highs of 58 to 62. Tonight, partly cloudy, breezy, and cool. Overnight lows 48 to 52.
Well, that's it. Have a great golf tournament down there. You enjoy yourself down in Orlando, Bryant. And I'll be in Deborah's hometown of Dalton, Georgia tomorrow night. And I'm going to be thinking of Jane Pauley when I read Doonesbury on Sunday. So I got the whole team in mind. All weekend. Have a ball.
Okay, Willard, thanks very much. You forgot Tom Brokaw. He's feeling bad because he's standing in the wings, where he's going to come in just a moment as we continue to take a look at San Francisco and the Bay Area's recovery efforts right after this.
The facts about butter and calories. Think butter has a ton of calories. Think again. Butter has just 36 calories a pat, the same as margarine. So for no more calories, you get butter's great taste, delicious dairy butter.
The new carpet.
Are you going to live in fear of your new carpet? Or buy the carpet with a 5-year warranty against wear, soil, and dirt? It's called worry-free. It's more than just stain resistant. It's totally worry-free. Most kids think that medicine has to taste bad. But not grape-flavored Dimetap Elixir.
You like Dimetap?
Grape-flavored Dimetap Elixir. It relieves kids as well as colds.
The two toughest cops in town are coming home on video cassette.
Kesham was boss.
All right, getting them back. It's okay.
James Belushi and Jerry Lee in K-9. Bring it home on video cassette starting November 16th from MCA Home Video.
Hey, what's this stuff?
Liquid Dial.
Why'd we switch?
This one has germ killer.
Our own liquid soap had germ killer.
No, it didn't.
Didn't?
Nope.
I thought it did.
Uh-uh.
What about the stuff before that?
It didn't.
It didn't?
Never.
Never?
Never, ever.
Thought it did.
You thought wrong, dear.
I did?
You did.
Mm-hmm.
Most liquid hand soaps don't kill germs. Liquid Dial does because it's made with a unique antibacterial formula.
I know. I bet the stuff we had way back...
Dad, it didn't.
Nah, didn't.
Liquid Dial. It's made to kill germs.
You know, when floods overrun communities, we are always struck by the residents' determination to rebuild. Same for those people who have lost homes, businesses to tornadoes or hurricanes. So I guess it comes as no surprise when we say that the quake has hurt a lot of folks here in the Bay Area, but few are being run out of town. This is the place they call home, and they're staying.
I've lived in San Francisco 13 years, and I would never move.
I've lived here 20 years. I came here from back east, and I'll never leave.
Hey, nobody leaves Hawaii because they have a hurricane, so I'm not leaving San Francisco. I love this place.
Never. I've lived here 29 years. Never move away. No.
If the people of the Bay were of a mind to, they'd certainly have a right to be scared. Consider this picture. The car was parked, yet the bricks are under the tires. In other words, the bricks came down with such force, they lifted the car right up off the ground. The dictionary defines resilience as the ability to recover quickly from illness, change, or misfortune. Applied to the Bay Area, it's very much in evidence here. Obviously, the people of the Bay and their communities have taken a beating. But just as obviously, they're anxious to get on with their lives. So while sites like this are commonplace, they are easily outnumbered by sites like this. People always talk to a cabbie. They get in the back of your hack. What do they say?
They say, where were you? You know, how are you getting through it? This and that. Are you making money today? And I say, yes, no, yes, no.
People in good spirits?
Pretty much they are in good spirits. They're still a little shocked at what's happened here.
But they're going about their business?
Yeah.
They're working?
Yeah. They're working. They're finally coming back into the city, like I said. So.
Any of them playing?
No, they're waiting until Tuesday. And the Giants come back.
People from the Midwest want to go back and never come back.
Yeah.
Yeah, but
as far as locals are concerned, I think the people pretty much have their mindset that this was something that we apparently are going to have, and this is, we're living on the San Andreas Fault, so it's to be expected.
You see all the regulars out here. I mean, you see the people who run this street every day. Have they all been back, or are they missing and drifting back in droves?
Everybody's sticking around.
Really?
Sure. Yeah. When the lights were out last night, you know, people were outside just they seemed to be enjoying the fact that there's a togetherness in the air, you know?
I think that the general feeling in the public is that they're happy that life's getting back to normal here.
The customers are talking a little more than usual about one specific subject, but other than that, it's another day at Max's.
They're getting on with business. It's obvious. Tom Brokaw has joined us inside the Moscone Center here. You've been here a couple of days. What have you been struck by?
Well, for one thing, I took a big helicopter tour the other day as soon as I got here at 6 in the morning after the earthquake, and I was very impressed by the resilience, to borrow your word, of the construction here. I went down through Stanford, which is very close to the San Andreas Fault. It's got all that kind of turn-of-the-century building. Nothing happened to it. Things have really held up very well. And downtown San Francisco, all those new high-rises, no damage.
I was
going to
say, particularly the taller buildings withstood the damage.
Yeah. So I think that we've learned a lot about how to build around earthquake faults, and this is about as severe a test as you're going to get for a time.
Yeah. People actually seem, I wouldn't say in good spirits about this, but they seem determined, and there's almost some, I don't want to say a business as usual attitude, but it's kind of an attitude that says, hey, you know what, this isn't the end of the earth, let's get on with it.
Yeah, politeness prevails almost everywhere. At Van Ness and O'Farrell the other day, one of the busiest intersections in town, no traffic lights,
yeah.
A lot of traffic, and people were pausing, no horn honking. I'd like to think the same thing would happen in New York as it has in the past a couple of times during blackouts, but it's a real test of a city, and this one has withstood it, I think, remarkably well.
When does that give way to the reality, as we know it, of red tape and bureaucracy?
Well, that's beginning to happen. Nerves are beginning to be frayed because small businesses are looking at the prospect of being shut down for several weeks. The rest of the city will recover, but a mom-and-pop restaurant out in the Marina District, for example, no gas, no power, and no straight answers from anyone, and they're getting to be pretty angry because they're looking at their livelihood and at their own lives.
Yeah. Even as we speak, we're hearing that the death toll is being revised downwards.
Right.
Are we ever going to know, are we ever going to get a number on either the injuries or on the financial toll?
It's very hard to calculate the financial toll because you take all those little residents, you take all those homes where there was damage, where there was no insurance of one kind or another, and other parts of the city are broken in ways that we can't see. Gas lines are broken and services are out, foundations are stressed, and the home may have to be condemned. No, when the mayor says that it's a $2 billion hit, that's probably accurate for the San Francisco area. And south of here, we can't forget, in Santa Cruz and Watsonville and
places
Hollister.
That are hard to get to up in the mountains.
They're hard to get to. There's been very little telephone service. Their whole main streets have been wiped out.
Yeah. How's the devastation of your aging body? I know you flew west to east on Tuesday and then east to west on Tuesday night, and now you're back to the Midwest tonight. You're
right. I'm still going through a series of aftershocks about 6.0 on the Richter scale here. But the people in this great city have a lot to be proud of, and in Northern California, because then you and I are partial to this area.
A little bit. Tom, take care of yourself.
Okay,
we'll see you later
you.
On NBC Nightly News. We're going to come back in just a moment. We're ahead right after this.
cancer wearers, here's some show-stopping news. This new Polident helps you fight tartar. Its new super strength now controls ugly tartar for an even better clean. Try my new super strength Polident. Controls tartar for a super clean.
Another day.
Another sandwich.
Might I suggest a proper hot lunch with Lunch Bucket Meals. From your microwave to your table in seconds. Lunch Bucket pasta and chicken, savory chicken and tender noodles.
Mmm, delicious.
So, what do you do for an encore?
Oh, chili with Tchaikovsky, perhaps. Lunch Bucket Meals, a proper hot lunch.
It's your mother.
Two calls at 8 p.m. from Dallas to Kansas City.
Are you getting enough to eat?
You sound thin.
With MCI's new primetime, this 20-minute call costs 29% less than with AT&T.
I'm fixing your favorite meatloaf.
Primetime lets you save no matter how far you call or how long you talk. So the choice that's right...
Bye-bye, dear.
...is the choice on the right. MCI's new primetime. Real savings 24 hours a day. Call now, get 1 month free.
I'm about to mindlessly spoon sugar into my coffee. So I'll have to do extra sit-ups. So after years of this habit, I'll have to do even more sit-ups. Eventually, I won't sleep at night. I'll just sit up. I could use Equal in my coffee and maybe forget all those extra sit-ups.
Equal tastes like real sugar because Equal is made with NutraSweet.
I know. Do the sit-ups anyway.
Equal. What a sweet choice.
More than 20 years, Renee Taylor and Joseph Bologna have been collaborating on stage and screen as actors, writers, and directors, and at home as husband and wife. Their latest combined effort is a film called It Had to Be You, a romantic comedy that opens in Los Angeles next week. And if that's not enough, your son Gabriel's in it, too.
Oh, yeah.
Who said this? In our relationship, there is no boss, period.
And that's final.
Absolutely is no boss. I mean, that's the high economic marriage.
Glad I asked. In the movie, you're sort of way out ahead of his character because you're going to fall, you're in love with him and he's going to fall in love with you, but he doesn't know you yet.
No, we're the perfect couple, only he doesn't know it.
He doesn't know it yet. That's from life, I take it.
Yeah. When I first met Joe, I said, I'm not going to see you again unless you're going to be serious. And he said, serious? I don't even know you. And I said, yeah, but when you do know me, you're going to love me. And when you love me, are you then going to be serious?
I don't know what she was talking about. I said, I guess so. It was so convoluted, but it sounded right.
You brought a picture along with you.
Yeah. We went to see the Dalai Lama because on our 25th anniversary, we're going to get married in a Buddhist ceremony.
And that's a year or so from now.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
The interesting thing about that picture, by the way, that was on the day he won the Nobel Peace Prize. And we met him. He was lecturing on compassion. Now, I don't know if you can see my expression here. Is that when I looked in this man's eyes, and there's such gentleness and such sweetness and such openness that I lit up.
And speaking of compassion, we're going to have an AIDS benefit, and everybody can join Madonna at 933-9244 Tuesday night for the Actors Fund for AIDS.
That's a really big deal, your movie and this benefit and the premiere.
Yeah, we're really excited
Things
about that.
Things are working very good for you two.
Renee's very good with props.
Yes. Fooled me. I had no idea that was coming.
No, I told them.
Yeah.
Tell me more about the story because I want to show a clip because it's...
It's a funny fatal attraction. It's a woman who gets a man up to her apartment and doesn't let him out until he gives her love, success, commitment, and the creative experience. It's what women who want to win have to get from men.
All right, she's an actress.
She's an actress.
And she's a writer, and things aren't going well. This is
desperate.
A loser in life.
Yes.
But this is her moment, and she thinks for some reason that this guy is her ticket to happiness and good fortune and whatever. Having said that, roll tape.
I think the sexiest thing in the whole world is to wear a fur coat with nothing on underneath. Don't you think that's sexy?
Yeah, I guess that'd be sexy.
Yeah, I think it's very sexy. See, I don't have anything on underneath. And it just feels great.
Why are you you doing this?
Look, this is silly. We're not teenagers. And I'm not good at manipulating. So, what do you think?
What was the question again?
All right, so if you're both directing this film, who yells action and who yells cut, and that's a print? And
well, we had a lot of fun. I would say action, darling, and he would say cut, darling.
You had to get special permission to do this from
did.
The Directors
we had to
Guild?
Go to the Directors Guild, well, it's not too often that two people, much less married couples. As a matter of fact, we're in the Guinness Book of Records, aren't
right.
we?
Right. We're the only husband and wife that write, direct, and star together and still sleep together. So far, but what's today?
I know, it's too early to figure it out.
I think you've got to get married again.
Yeah. We are. Yeah. Will you come?
Yeah. Oh, thanks. Oh, I'd love to.
A Buddhist ceremony, they throw you up in the air.
What do you wear to a
white, simple white and diamonds.
That's you, but I'm thinking about, never mind. We'll be back in a moment. First, a message.
This is your captain speaking. We've just reached our cruising altitude of 31,000 feet. And in a moment, the flight attendants will begin serving lunch and...
Captain, we forgot the Colombian coffee.
...100% Colombian coffee, hand-picked by Juan Valdez. It's the richest coffee in the world.
Arnie's performance has been nothing short of amazing. He hasn't missed a putt all day. He's got about 15 feet to the hole. The ball should break slightly to his right. Just look at the steely determination in those eyes.
This is what a golf course would look like if it had the Lanier Copier performance guarantee.
He's done it again.
Lanier Copiers, guaranteed to be up and running at least 98% of the time.
Betty, how do you do it? Your new creamy deluxe frosting. How could it taste so good and have no cholesterol? Ooh, darling, how do you do the sweet things you do?
You sweet talker, Betty Crocker.
Coming on video cassette.
Dig 'em up!
It's The Runaway. Comedy hit. Extremely funny, said the Boston Globe. A hoot of a comedy, said the Today Show. It's Martin Short and Nick Nolte, and they're on the loose. In Three Fugitives, rented November 1st on video cassette.
People do this. People do that. People sleep on their side, front and back. Of all the things that people do, there's one thing that's also true. More people sleep on silly posturepedic. Yes, they do. More people sleep on silly posturepedic. So should you.
Almost goes without saying this has been a painful week for those of the Bay Area, a time of great tragedy and loss. Just 3 days after the earthquake, San Francisco continues to dust itself off, and with time comes a bit of perspective. Certainly all are saddened by the loss of life, but we must be thankful that it wasn't much worse. As we close out what's been a rather unforgettable week, we bring you some reminders of nature's fury and images of a force perhaps even more powerful, the human spirit.
Get Dave Parker at second base, so the Oakland A's take.
Hey, well, we're having an earthquake.
All of a sudden, in front of me, there were cracks, like they instantly appeared. People start running into the walls of the Bay Bridge. There were big splits, and actually, the freeway had dropped. At this point, we thought we were in immediate danger. Was five known and confirmed dead, but they do appear there are three others in the draft.
Downtown with a lot of gas in the air, but luckily no fires broke out because there's also a water pressure problem downtown.
There's a lot of pockets in the structure in the upper deck that are cracked up, and there has to be someone in there that's still alive. I believe there is.
Thank you.
happen.
Valuables and all the potential.